I believe that abortion should be safe and legal in this country. I believe that since Roe v. Wade has been the law for 20 years, that we should sustain and support it.
That I have consistently been pro-life and pro-life and pro-life.
Great things about our nation, Sally, is that we're each entitled to have strong personal beliefs, and we encourage other people to do the same. But as a nation, we recognize the right of all people to believe as they want and not to impose our beliefs on other people. I believe that abortion should be safe and legal in this country. I have since the time that my mom took that position when she ran in 1970 as a U.S. Senate candidate.
On the question of the choice issue, I have supported the Roe v. Wade. I am pro-choice. My opponent is multiple choice.
Ken, multiple choice, I've got to...
Mr. Romney, you have 15 seconds to rebut that.
On the idea of multiple choice, I have to respond. I have my own beliefs, and those beliefs are very dear to me. One of them is that I do not impose my beliefs on other people. Many, many years ago, I had a dear, close family relative that was very close to me who passed away from an illegal abortion. It is since that time that my mother and my family have been committed to the belief that we can believe as we want, but we will not force our beliefs on others on that matter.
Absolutely. I'll say the same thing to you that I've said since 1994 and probably before, and that is that on a personal basis, I don't favor abortion. However, as governor of the Commonwealth, I will protect the right of a woman to choose under the laws of the country and the laws of the Commonwealth. That's the same position I've had over many, many years. Very clear.
Shannon snuck a little extra point in there that I want to address, and that is with regards to my views with regards to protecting a woman's right to choose. And I've been very clear on that. I will preserve and protect a woman's right to choose, and am devoted and dedicated to honoring my word in that regard. I will not change any provisions of Massachusetts's pro-choice laws.
Committed to my promise to maintain the status quo with regards to laws relating to abortion and choice, so far I've been able to successfully do that, and my personal philosophical views about this issue are not something that I think would do anything other than distract from what I think is a more critical.
I was sitting down with the head of the stem cell research department of Harvard and the provost of Harvard University, and they were explaining these techniques to me, and I somehow imagined in my mind this embryo farming. Embryo farming is taking donor sperm and donor eggs and putting them together in a laboratory and creating a new embryo. And if that's not creating life, I don't know what is. And I imagined just row after row after row of racks of these, either by a cloning process or by this farming process. And at that point, one of the two gentlemen said, Governor, there's really not a moral issue at stake here. And he said, because we destroy the embryos at 14 days. And I have to tell you that that comment and that perspective hit me very hard. And as he left the room with his colleague, I turned to Beth Myers, my chief of staff, and said, I want to make it real clear. We have so cheapened the value and sanctity of human life in our society that someone could think there's not a moral issue because we kill human embryos at 14 days.
have no court convictions.
Well, as I just indicated, look at my record as governor. There's one place of significance where I changed my position, which was with regards to abortion. I've described that in some depth as to why that was. That happened a couple of years ago as it related to the debate going on in our state about cloning and embryo farming. I'm happy to have people take a look at my record as governor. My record as governor and the positions I took as governor are clear and straightforward, and those are positions I'm proud of today. As a governor, for instance, every step I took with regards to abortion was on the side of life.
Mitt Romney himself went out that Ronald Reagan was pro-choice at one point in his life and then became pro-life, as did George H.W. Bush. It's not uncommon that people have a change of position. It's problematic for Romney. He's always going to have to explain not just what position he takes, but why he moved in that direction. But there's flattery here for Mitt Romney. He can take comfort. We're getting near deer season all over the country. Guess what? You never shoot at the deer that's dead.
People have had a chance to look at my record, and look what I've said as I've been through that last campaign. I believe people understand that I'm firmly pro-life. I will support justices who believe in following the Constitution and not legislating from the bench, and I believe in the sanctity of life from the very beginning until the very end.
Is there anybody here who believes that that's an issue in the campaign, or is it case closed?
Case closed.
Case closed it is. All right, let's move on.